Hadley presents Apple Videos. Today we'll check out exploring the Seeing AI app, Low Vision. Hello, my name is Douglas Walker. I tell you, I am super excited because today we are going to be checking out one of my all-time favorite apps. We will be exploring a Microsoft app called Seeing AI. You know, that's pretty great. A Microsoft app on our Apple device. Who would have thought it, right? Anyway, our Seeing AI app is really like having several apps in one because it does so many different things. And it uses our device's back-facing camera for accomplishing most of our tasks. And best of all, our Seeing AI app is absolutely free. And hey, we all love something free, right? Okay, today we are going to be exploring how to navigate our Seeing AI screen or interface. And we'll also check out where to get tips for learning how to use all of our built-in features, or what Microsoft calls channels. So how about we jump right in? Now, when our Seeing AI app first opens, it will open in the last feature or channel that we happen to be using. And we just so happen to be placed here in our short text channel, which is actually our app's first channel. Now, it's good to know that we have a menu button in the top left corner of our screen here. All right, activating our menu button will open a dialog box where we can find things like our settings and even a really great help file. Now, we're not going to be totally exploring our menu button today because today is all about exploring our app interface. Yeah, we also have a quick help button in the top right-hand corner of our screen, and activating our quick help button will provide us with some really great tips for the channel that we currently have open. And remember, we're currently in our short text channel here. You know, our quick help button is a super useful feature for quickly getting us up and running with our app. Okay, moving right along. Now, it's good to know that we have been given a pause announcement button towards the bottom of our screen here and just above our channel selector. Okay, since we're in our short text channel, our device is using our back-facing camera to try to find and read any text. Of course, we're flat on a surface here, so we're not going to be able to read any text, but it tries to read whatever we're hovering above here. And I tell you, this can start to get a bit annoying, so it's good to know that we can simply just touch here and we can temporarily pause or mute our speech if we like. And that's pretty handy there. Okay, our last element here is our channel selector. And you probably already guessed that our channel selector gives us the ability to switch between our different channels or features here. Who would have thought it, right? Anyway, we can see that we're currently on our short text channel because it's actually highlighted blue for us here. Now, our short text channel gives us the ability to read short phrases or passages of text, like we said, and that's super useful. If, you know, maybe we want to tell the difference between our shampoo or our conditioner, or even if we want to make sure that we are drinking a caffeine-free drink instead of a regular cola. Yeah, and we can move to our next channel here simply by scrolling through or kind of dragging our finger to our left, and we just simply touch to select our new channel here. So, you know, let's give it a try. We'll just drag it over here and we'll just touch our next
document
channel. Great. So here's our document channel. And we have the ability here to actually take a picture of a full page of text and have it read to us. That is really handy for us there. So that's our document channel. So we'll just scroll to our next one here and we'll touch.
Product.
Yeah, and this is our product channel. So this is actually like a barcode scanner. So we can hold this above any product virtually and get information about that product. Tell us what we're having for dinner so we don't have to play a guessing game in our pantry there. So we'll just scroll to our left to our next channel.
Person.
Now, this is a fun channel. You can actually, and our quick tips can tell us how to do this, but you can actually take a picture of somebody and store their name and their photo within the app here. And then when we point the camera towards that person, we're actually told who that is in our room. So that's pretty neat. And now, word to the wise, if they're not stored in here and you take a picture of the person, it tries to guess their age. So that can kind of be a dangerous channel depending upon who we're looking at there. So we'll just move on to our next channel.
Currency.
Here. Yeah, and here's our currency channel. So easy to guess that this tells us what denomination of money we might have, whether we have a dollar bill, $5, $10, $20 bill there. So really handy to have. We'll go to our next channel here.
Scene preview.
This is really cool. This is called scene preview. You can actually take a picture of whatever scene you're in or the surroundings that you're in, and it can tell you what kind of surroundings you have, whether there's a bridge there or trees, it tries to determine whether you're in a dining area or a living room or cafeteria. So kind of cool scene preview here. Keep scrolling to our left.
Color preview, green.
Yeah, and here's our color preview. And remember, it's trying to use our back-facing camera, and it's kind of a tan background. It's trying to say it's green here. Looks kind of black because we're sitting flat on a surface here. So, yep, pretty cool to have a color preview there, or color channel.
Handwriting preview.
And this is similar to our document, except this one, actually, you take a picture of handwriting, and it actually does a pretty good job, if it's print handwriting there, at recognizing that and turning it into text for us to be able to read here. Very cool. And I believe this is our last channel. We'll tap it here.
Light.
Yep, we knew we'd have to use that pause button there to pause our sound there, because what we have with this light channel is it uses our back-facing camera to determine how much light we have coming into our camera. So the tone was very low there, so not much light's coming here because, of course, it's placed flat on a surface. But if I were to raise this up and point it towards our studio lights here, it would gradually increase, and we'd hear a higher and higher pitch sound for our camera there. Pretty great. Okay, so light again is our last channel here. And, you know, we can just scroll back to our right to move back through all of our channels, like we said. So we'll just scroll back to short text here, and we'll select our short text. You know, our Seeing AI app just does so much. And I tell you, it's definitely worth the price, right? Again, my name is Douglas Walker. Take care, and I'll see you next time. For more Apple videos, visit the Hadley website at www.hadley.edu.